I see DCF questions all the time on social media. Why to use one, when to use one, questions about specific components of it. This video should simplify things for you. I'm not going to go over how to do a basic DCF. You don't need me for that. That's covered all over the internet. The DCF is an income approach to valuation that looks overused relative to capitalizing free cash flow. It doesn't matter if we're using a DCF, market multiples, or capitalizing cash flow. We're looking at cash flow and the risk associated with those cash flows. I have a question. These reflect annual free cash flow growth over a complete business cycle. For which scenario would you use a DCF? The answer is none of them because they all have constant growth rates built in. You might be thinking that this isn't constant growth, but you can see that it's just two constant growth rates. So you take the average. There's no advantage to modeling out each year. I know this may disappoint some of you because you've learned this new method and want to put it to use, but it just isn't necessary. It is sometimes, other times, but here instead you'd capitalize free cash flow because it's the same thing. You want your DCF to be as supportable as possible, and forecasts are always wrong. There are many ways to calculate free cash flow, and if your company has no debt or is situated in an industry that doesn't use debt, then you should probably use free cash flow to equity. This is the formula I prefer, just a personal choice. Let's just quickly run through a capitalization example, because there are a few small differences compared to a DCF model. Okay, remembering our formula, the first difference is that here you're normalizing free cash flow. You don't need to do this with a DCF because you obviously wouldn't model in unusual or non-recurring items. If your sales are going to grow, you'll need to account for working capital provisions. You want to smooth your net working capital provisions to reflect the model's constant long-term growth. So this part of free cash flow hinges on your working capital to sales ratio. You can use your company's historical sales to working capital ratio, but again, you'll likely want to smooth it out. You can also use a number from comparable companies. You'd probably have to pull these numbers yourself, but it shouldn't take long at all. There are also specialized sources like RMA's annual statement studies that provide ratios by industry. Here's a sample page from the report, and you can see it's broken down by industry. They have various operating ratios, and down here is sales to working capital, which you have to invert to turn into working capital to sales. You just take the inverse. And they break it down by size and provide quartile information and mean and medians. Okay, we've worked through our net working capital and we've arrived at our adjusted normalized free cash flow to the firm. And we worked through a standard capitalization problem, basically a dividend discount model, except using the firm's capacity to generate future cash flow. And we come across this unusual item, excess cash and marketable securities. We're looking now at cash that isn't used in day-to-day operations of the company. Apple is one example, but let's look at the actual calculation. This calculation is for excess cash, but you can do this using a working capital adjustment instead if you want. It depends on the reality of the company's balance sheet. So you finish the calculation and it flows through to the capitalization of cash flow added back to equity. Back to the DCF. They're best used when you have erratic results or two or three stage growth as with high growth companies. I rarely use a 5-year DCF and prefer not to forecast altogether. You want a model that isn't attackable. In the professional world, these valuations can be used in litigation or you have to defend them against the IRS for tax purposes and they need to be defendable. One last item is discounting. When you discount at n equals 1, 2, 3, etc., that models in cash flows being received at the end of each year, but that isn't realistic at all. Using n equals 0.5 for the first year, and so on and so forth, is an easy, though not perfect, fix here. I think that's enough for today, but stay tuned for more on these topics, and thank you for watching, and please like the video and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.